Good morning. Today we will discuss the timing diagram for memory write. Memory write machine cycle. In memory write, there are three T states required. Okay, data available in accumulator. Now accumulated data to transfer into data bus. Now data bus data to transfer into that particular memory address. This is the concept of to write a memory write operation. Okay, first we have to initialize the what is the memory address. Okay, there are three T states required for memory write machine cycle. Okay, during the T1 T states, microprocessor places the 16 bit address, the address available in HL pan, that address to place into higher order address bus and low order address bus. The microprocessor places the 16 bit address, the address available in HL register pair. Now the HL register pair address to place into higher order address bus and low order address bus, AD02, AD7 and A8 to A15. Second one, during T1 T stage, initially ALE signal it goes to I state up to middle of the T1 T states. During this stage, it will select the address bus. After that, middle of the T1 T states, the ALE signal will goes to low state up to the end of the T3 states. At that time, it will select the data buses. Okay. Next one, to identify which machine cycle we are using. Okay. For that, you can use the status signal. The status signal only it will identify what type of machine cycle we are using. Your memory write. Memory write means now to select the IO bar, memory bar equal to 0. This is for 0 means it will select the memory. Okay. And then to write the data. To write the data to memory. Okay, now to select the write operation, status signal S01 and S1 0 conditions. Now it will select the memory write operation. Next, during T2 T states, the write signal low when middle of the T2 and middle of the T3 states, the write signal it goes to low state and the remaining it will goes to high state. During middle of the T2 and T3, it will write the data for that to set into low state. Next, the content of the accumulator. Okay, data will be available in the accumulator. Now accumulator data to place into data bus. Okay, to place into data bus. During the T3 T states, data available in the data bus. Now the data to transfer to the memory location, the which memory location data to write. Okay, the data placed on the data bus is transfer to the memory locations. After that, the middle of the P3 these days, the write signal goes to I. At that time, it will disable state of the write operation. Okay, for this, we have to draw the timing diagram. For that, it requires 3 T states. Okay, first, signals. This is for memory write machine cycle. There are 3 T states required: T1, T2, and T3. First T1, T2, and T3. First, clock pulse. Clock pulse always first it will goes to low state, middle of the T1, and it will goes to high state. Half of the T states it goes to low, and the remaining half of the T states it will goes to high state. Again T2 initially low, and it will goes to high. Next it low, and it will goes to high state. This is the clock pulse initialization. Next to initialize the higher order address A8 to A15. For that, there are 2 lines, one for low and one for high. It will goes to up to end of the T3 states. It will maintain the constant. Now to initialize the address in HL register, for higher order address available in HL memory address. Next, AD0 to AD7 address bus and data bus for loader. There are 2 signals, one signal for low and one signal for high. Okay, first it will select the address bus. For that, it will goes to up to T2 middle. It will select the higher order address, lower byte address. Next, middle of the T2, it will select the data, and middle of the T3, D0 to D7. Here it will select the data bus, and remaining will be don't get conditions. Next, ALE signal, address latch enabled. Initially, it will select the address bus. Okay, for that, ALE signal I stay. During the middle of the T1, it will goes to low state up to end of the T3 states. Here, it will select the address bus, and here it will select the data bus. Next, to identify what type of machine cycles, for that we can use the status signal IO or memory bar S0, S1. For that we can use the 2 lines, one for low signal and one for high signal. Now this will be constant throughout the end of the T3 states. Now we have to initialize input output bar memory bar. This is for memory write, means we have to select the memory signal low, and write operation. Write means S1 equal to 0 and S0 equal to 1. Now it will select for memory write machine cycle. And to write the data, data available in accumulator. Now accumulator data to transfer into data bus. Now this data bus data to read, sorry, to write. For that we have to use the control signal write, to write the data to memory. When during the T2 and T3 T state, middle of the during T2 and T3, it will write the data to memory, from data bus to memory. At the time the write signal will be low state. Read not required. At that time read signal will be high state. Okay? And after middle of the T3 states, again write signal it will goes to high state. At that time write will be disabled state. This is the timing diagram for memory write machine cycle. Okay? Any doubt? Thank you.